What's up, Exiles? Advance here, and today I want to talk about my Bloodseeker build. I've reached level 100 with this build at the Hardcore Pyrandus League, but to tell the truth, it's not so powerful like my previous World Toxic build. Anyway, I think it's pretty unique and hardcore viable. I decided to create my build around the skill puncture, and as you can see, the DPS is good enough for comfortable game at the endgame maps, but the AoE is not really good. That's because this build is not using chain. I decided to play with pierce, cause at this patch it gives more damage. This build is best reveals itself in the group, cause when you play solo, mobs dying from flood damage, only rare mobs and bosses can feel the power of the damage over time. So the final tooltip DPS on puncture in town is near 13k, and with flask and charges near 60k. I cannot calculate pure .dps from breed and poison, but it looks great. Let's see my defense. I play with acrobatics and face acrobatics. With help of Grace Aura I have 10k evasion, and in combined with arrow dancing it is really good defense against projectile attacks. Also life pool in 7.2k is not so bad for hardcore archer. So let's start from the links. To sustain frenzy and power charges, I use frenzy, GMP, power charge on critical and faster attack. Next goes default custom damage taking gem setup with enfeeble and immortal call. Next goes main skill, puncture, GMP, increased critical damage, pierce, slower projectiles and rapid decay. You can use some different gem setups depending on your gear. As example, until I got good bow, I used physical projectile attack damage gem instead of rapid decay. But later, when the DPS has raised, I decided to cancel some damage nodes and switch to rapid decay, cause the physical damage reflection became too dangerous for me. Next goes increased duration, blood rage, wall haste and wall lightning trap gem for boss fights, and finally there are some auras in corrupted clothes. By the way, the corrupted snake bites with vulnerability on hit is very important part of this build. It gives really great DPS boost, especially dot DPS. This is particularly felt in the fights against stationary bosses like wall. Also try to find rare helmet with enchantment for vulnerability curse effect, it's also very helpful. Other uniques in this build are Belly of the Beast and Drill Neck. At the early game you can use Lion-Eyes Glare with a good damage roll, but later you should switch to a Harbinger Bow with a 9% base crit and more than 300 DPS. As for bandits, I use following setup, normal Orc, Cruel Crichton and Merciless Alira. For the early game you can help Orc and Cruel, but at the late game when you will have too much damage it is better to switch it for an additional attack speed. Few words about subclass. I choose the Assassin because in my server crafting I've planned to use Merlin's Fallacy unique amulet, so my crit rate should be extremely high. But later I decided to abandon this idea and switch it from Ambush to Toxic Delivery Keystone. But right now I think that Assassin may be not the best choice for this build. You can experiment with an Elementalist and Conflux for better AoE and shock, or maybe a Scion with an Assassin and Deadeye combo for additional projectile, projectile speed bonus and 50% chance to pierce. Okay, finally here is my current tree and jewel setup. Good luck, stay safe, and guys, please don't play on champion subclass.